be doing all originals and maybe even talk a little bit about how they came about. That one, Losing End, was one of about 23 songs that Ron and I got together. I think it was in like the fall of, when was it? Fall of a long time ago. We knocked out about 23 songs in 6 or 7 weeks. Not all of them made it to, you know, get played out, but a lot of them did. This is one of them, Losing End.
Thank you.
and we started waxing on it, and it was a rumba. What the heck? I didn't know we were in a rumba, but we did it. It's called So Wrong for Each Other, We're Almost Right.
Thank you. told this story before, so I'll make it, try to make it a little briefer tonight. This guy I know, and he's a bar owner, and he likes to drink.
Yeah.
Surprise. And when he gets to drinking, he asks me, "How you doing?" He says, "I'm all right. I'm all right." The song's called "Doing I."
Thank you.
a good one. I like that. When Diana, by the way, I should first say, Diana Jacobs is completely responsible for all of this mess. If you think it stinks, talk to her. Don't talk to us. When Diana first asked us about doing an all-original thing, we thought, okay, that'd be cool. And then we realized that, holy crap, we gotta learn some songs. We had to go back to the first CD and relearn three or four tunes that we just weren't doing anymore. Maybe we do. Maybe we learned them. We'll find out, won't we? You learned them. You got them. This one is called Such a Fool. I'm such a fool. Take me don't be cold. Just give me a kiss. Say I love you.
Thank you.
next one. This is from the Roller Coaster Blues CD, and it has changed a bit since we started doing it. We recorded it one way, and then we started doing it a different way, and we'll just see where that goes. It's called Your Kiss. working on that 23 songwriting thing where I did. It's called What I Wouldn't Do.
I'm too old, it ain't gonna happen. And I come over to see you.
losing so much of it. Why don't you just sit down and enjoy yourself? Stop being.
I know you do.
I'm surprised you don't have the drone in here flying around.
That's next week.
This song is probably the oldest original that we do. Ron wrote it long before I ever thought about joining the band.
Right?
This was off the Night Crew CD back in 96.
1896?
1796. This is called Burning Desire. I'm 25 or 30 years ago. And the band I was at the time didn't really want to do originals, so we didn't do it. I brought up when I joined Ron Spencer Band, so we did for a while, and then we kind of stopped doing it. Kind of faded away, so I had to go back and run over to this one too. Well, it's also our drums over there. Sooner or later, whether you like it or not.
Yeah.
You like them.
If they wanted to hear the hair piled high line, you can sing it. Now I'm out of the equation too.
Looks like Ross is going to have to sing it. Although his hair isn't exactly piled high, but he's got it. We will live. There's some slide tunes and originals, and this is one of them. This is from the Soul Reason CD. I should probably say that both of the CDs are for sale over at Ron Mart, which is over by the door there. I think they're less than $100 a piece, aren't they?
$90
less?
Million.
$10 million. $10 a piece. Ground. They make great Christmas presents. Yes. They're our stuff. It's our stuff. Alright, this one. This is one of those songs that came up because Ron Taylor Crowley came up with a riff. And he said, "You have any words that'll fit this?" And I'm flipping through my notebook real quick and I found something. It was, Diane, you'll appreciate this. It was inspired by a James Baldwin novel.
This is actually two songs.
It is?
Yeah. The ending part is completely different.
That's right. Yeah. The Janet bit at the end.
It's our day in the life song.
Not even freaking close. Count 6 of 1 and half a dozen of the other. So when Beale Street talks, you better remember the name of the title of the song.
Six of one, half a dozen of the other. Six of one, half a dozen of the other.
and suffering. You give us big heads.
We don't get out the door.
Thank you.
This one is one that we kind of just came up with a crack, and I think everybody voted. Everybody contributed. I gave you the title. And we went from there. It's called Working on Her Sins.
Working on the city, she don't do what I want to do.
This one hasn't made it to a CD yet, but it will, I'm sure. It's, I wrote this about my hometown, Missouri, which I love dearly, and I hate dearly. It's a little strange. Alright, here we go. It's called Call to Me.
still love doing this song.
We've been doing it for probably 8 or 9 years. I still love it. It's the title song from the Roller Coaster Blues CD.
Here about what sort of goes. Usually at rehearsals,
Mark might have some lyrics in his life. Never had any lyric book that he's had there.
I should tell him the story about how they disappeared.
Okay, well, tell him the story.
We had to play a job over in Ellicottville, and we all piled into Ron's van, and we were getting ready to leave. We backed out of his driveway, and we started down the street. And it occurred to me, wait a minute, I don't think we closed the back door. The back door. And Ron's like, oh, no, we didn't. I said, and Jay got out. Jay was the bass player at the time. He got out, and sure enough, we hadn't closed it. Shut it down, thought everything was fine. Got to Ellicottville, and found that my bag that had my microphone cord, and worst of all, my lyric book. The other things we here in place, the lyric book was screwed. So I have a new lyric book. And I really hate people who sit there and read their lyrics. But this is a song we're just learning. It's not complete yet. So I think I'm okay.
Yeah, so this is how it goes. So, Mark says he's got some lyrics, or I might just start playing a riff just in between any songs that we're rehearsing. And Mark goes, what's that? What are you doing there? And I go, well, I don't know, it's just something I'm doing here. And he goes, well, let me see. So, opens up his book and he goes, wait a minute, I think I might have something here. So, the next thing you know, we're playing a song, I guess.
Yeah, sort of, kind of. So, this is, I would never have been able to write this if I still lived in Missouri. It's called Baby It's Cold Outside. Not Baby, it's just cold outside.
Bye.
I said I couldn't have written that in Missouri. I had to come up here and do that.
Damn.
Maybe I've been up here. I've been up here longer than I live in Missouri. And I still haven't gotten used to rooms.
Oh!
You provide the words. So I did. It's called Soul Reason.
I like this one. One, two.
Thank you. your songs left for you.
So we're going to go to somebody's house.
So we're going to have to go to somebody's house and we'll play there. That's too damn far away, Rick.
Yeah. It's not that far away.
It's not that far away.
Here I am. Cool.
We're going to end up tonight with a couple of slide chills. This is one of those songs where Ron had a riff and came up with something.
You're high on me.
call you to the fact. Believe it or not, when I brought this song to Ron, I had in mind a whole